the software, mm-hmm. sets up the call, brings down the directory, so that you can see who else is on there if you've got to talk to.
So, of course, you can only call somebody who's also logged onto the web at that particular time, right?
Absolutely. So you almost have to tell them ahead of time that you're going to be
yeah.
doing that.
All right. So who are we going to call here?
We're going to be calling Mr. Memory from...
From Quarterdeck.
From Quarterdeck,
yeah. A.K.A. Gary Saxer, I believe.
Right.
Okay, and there he is.
There he is. And dial in.
All right, so it knows what his address is there.
Absolutely. You need to go to the server so the server can determine his address. That's
yeah.
You've got dynamic addressing now, so it's...
Now, how does he know you just called him?
I think he rings his in. Sounds like a telephone.
Huh, okay.
Gary, you online? Why, I certainly am. Good to hear from you.
Hey, there he is. Works.
You notice the sound quality is excellent.
Yes, to say a little bit, Gary.
Oh, of course it works. This is Quarterdeck's web talk product.
Yeah, it does sound very good. Now, what's that little graphic? So Gary, you're in New York here, huh?
Well, yes, the graphic allows you to show you wherever you are. Actually, it can show us wherever you are anywhere in the world. It sort of gives you an idea about how far away somebody is talking. For instance, if I were in Paris, the map would look at you're in California
wow.
and I'm in Paris, and it automatically updates and changes.
All right, now the cool thing, Rob and Gary, is that we can call New York or call Paris, and if we're using the net, we're only paying for a local phone call, right?
Absolutely. That makes that's quite an advantage. Of course, we've got a lot. That's correct. On each side, it's a local phone call. Right. For instance, when my wife calls her parents, we run about $200 a month up, and it saves a lot of money.
All right, so this may be a little complicated. You got to set up a couple of things, but if you use it a lot, and if there's certain people you call all the time, you can save a heck of a lot of money here.
A lot of money.
And as we heard the call...
If there are certain people you're going to call, you can save a lot of money. I'm aware of quite a few people who make up the cost of the product in the first month of having the product.
Yeah, I can see
that.
Just
in long distance phone
calls. Not unusual.
All right, so this is real stuff. I can make phone calls, call my mom anywhere around the world.
Pretty much, yep.
All right, Rob, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
FedEx, Perry Short, may I help you? Can I help you? FedEx, Perry Short, can I help you?
That package was signed for on September the 9th at 11:44 a.m.
That package was signed for on September the 9th at 11:44 a.m.
right, so there's you at our end.
Right, here's the wire at our end.
And you're calling Ed.
Right, and here comes Ed now.
And yeah, hey, there he is.
Hey, Ed, how are you doing? Are you there?
Hey, Tony, how's it going? Good you called. I was just watching the news online.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, glad you could make a few moments for us.
All right. Explain, would you now, Tony, some of the parameters you can control. I see you've got quality and motion and stuff. What are the knobs you've got to turn here?
Right. Basically, because even though we have a 20-day connection to Internet, our bandwidth may vary anywhere from 20-day all the way down to almost nothing.
Depending on the network traffic.
We need to be able to select the motion versus quality. And our product is able to scale the video quality in terms of whether you'd like to see more motion or more quality.
Mm-hmm.
So it's basically a trade-off you make with this kind of slider here. You want more motion, you get more motion. More quality, you get more quality.
All right. Now, what kind of picture are you seeing over there, Ed? Does Tony look clear to you? Now, is that lag that's built in here?
It could be lag. Ed, we're just wondering what kind of picture you're getting. Maybe the microphone's not picking up here.
Tony's coming through pretty clearly. The video is pretty excellent, and his audio is coming through fine.
All right, so what is the frame right now which we're looking at, Ed?
Yeah, we have a little tool here that continuously analyzes the network, and we can see basically at this point in time we're getting one frame, and we're sending one frame per second from him. If the connection is of a better quality, we'll see typically between 5 to 8 frames per second.
Real quick, Tony, what's it cost me to be able to have this capability?
If you've got the right hardware, basically the software will be in the $100 to $200 area. Typically, you already have a sound blaster,
right.
So the video capture card will be something that's going to cost you, again, between another $100
right.
and $200.
And a local phone call again.
And a local phone call, that's it.
I missed Miami's game yesterday. How'd they do?
Really strong. Looks like a pretty solid team. We'll have to see what happens when they meet the home team here.
Weren't you telling me that they have...
This is where they will go.
It's awesome. They have... You can
see...
Well, I haven't been there yet. I'll check it out, too.
So this is like classic Doonesbury?
Yeah, you can see what's going on in the country at that time as well, with the highlights from the news that week.
Cool.
A little time machine action.
I just remember that he had something to do with the Grateful.
You can make your avatar look happy, and you can change to sad. You can even look angry, and finally.
Now, what is Timecast? That's something you got up here. How do I use Timecast?
Well, Timecast is our TV guide to real audio content. Gets around the issue of there's all this great content
right.
to listen to. I want to find it fast. And
so I can sort of go on here and say, tell me the audio stuff that's available on the web right now.
That's exactly right. It's broken into three major features. Live Now is actually a feature that breaks out all the live events that are happening every 10 minutes.
So, like, these are actual, this is audio coverage of football, college football games
that's
that are going
right.
on. So I can just click on one and listen to play-by-play of my favorite team's football game.
You bet. Anytime you want, anywhere in the world.
Okay, what are all the other things here?
Well, we have about 150 radio stations that are broadcasting real audio 24 hours
really?
A day, 7 days a week. So if I selected rock, for example, I actually preset one of these radio stations, and it's actually playing in the background here.
What station are you listening to? I can program this stuff you're saying by type, so I can say, hey, I want a rock station or I want a jazz station.
That's
something
exactly
I can
right.
do on my radio.
You got it.
All right, that's cool. All right, now, you can also do news kind of stuff on this, right?
Right. We have about 30 vendors.
So I could, like assemble, I mean, we've heard about, you know, assembling your private newspaper. This is really assembling my private personal radio newscast?
That's exactly right.
Huh. All right, so tell me what you're doing there.
Well, I just started up the page, and I've actually selected a number of things I like to go back to every day. So what it'll play on the left-hand side here is a couple of selections. I like industry news. I like some financial information as well as sports.
So you've selected the audio sources you want to compile, and it'll automatically go pull down those things for you. And you can go click and listen to a five-minute newscast with your pre-selected
That's
topics?
Exactly right. So you basically roll your own newscast, and here it's playing
can we
in
hear
the background.
It?
You bet.
And we chat about families and computing with the PC Dad.
Wow.
While hackers may be taking out their wrath on U.S. government sites like the Department of Justice and
so
just the other day the
CIA.
This is changing the whole domain out there, isn't it? Two quick
yeah.
questions. What does it cost me to do this stuff? What
In a move that has angered Democrats, presidential nominee Bob Dole is really today.
Let me introduce the landing team. Ludger Brink is a noted...
The shuttle is up and away.